In this video, we have three resistors in a circuit. One of the resistors is by itself and will be labeled resistor 1. Then the other two resistors are in parallel right after the first resistor. These resistors will be labeled as resistor 2 and resistor 3. I will be taking real-world measurements using a digital multimeter at the right of the screen. To be honest, I'm making this video because I just got a new breadboard and I wanted to break it in. As per the measurement, there is 5 volts going to the circuit, and the resistor's values are 21.8 kiloohms for resistor 1, 4.6 kiloohms for resistor 2, and 9.8 kiloohms for resistor 3. Now, in order to complete this problem, we'll have to know how series circuits work and parallel circuits work. You can check out these videos as a refresher. We will start out by finding the resistance total of the total circuit. We can view the circuit as a resistor in series with a parallel circuit attached to it in series. So if we find the total resistance of the resistor in parallel, we can treat it as two resistors in series. That being said, we can take the resistance 1 plus the resistance total of the parallel portion of the circuit to get the total resistance. The resistance total of the parallel portion can be found by taking 1 over parentheses 1 over resistance 2 plus 1 over resistance 3 parentheses. We can now plug in the resistances into the formula. After plugging in the formula into our calculator, we get a total resistance of 24.93 kiloohms. Now we can treat the circuit as if it is a single resistor with the value of the resistance total we found of 24.93 kiloohms. Recall that V equals IR, or in other words, voltage equals current times resistance. We can rearrange the formula to get the voltage over the resistance to be equal to the total current in the circuit. After plugging in our 5 volts voltage source and the resistance total of 24.93 thousand ohms, we have a current of 0.2 milliamps for our total current. For this next step, we need to think of current as if it is water in a river. If there is only one path for the water or current to go, the total volume of water must flow through that path. That being said, resistor 1 has the total current going through it. This means that once again, we can use V equals IR and plug in the resistance of resistor 1 of 21.8 kiloohms and current total of 0.2 milliamps. We get a voltage at resistor 1 of 4.36 volts. Recall that the total voltage being applied to a series circuit equals the sum of each resistor's voltage. So we can rearrange this to get the voltage of the circuit minus the voltage of R1 being equal to the voltage of resistor 2 and resistor 3. Plugging in our numbers, we get that 5 volts minus 4.36 volts is equal to the voltage at resistor 2 and resistor 3, which is 0.64 volts. Now to get the current at each resistor, we can take the voltage at R2 and R3 and divide it by the resistance value of each resistor. At R2 we have a current of 0.139 milliamps, and at R3 we have a current of 0.065 milliamps. To check our work, we can add up both of the currents at resistor 2 and resistor 3 to see if it adds up to the total flow rate, which in this case is close to the same value but varies slightly due to the rounding at various stages in this problem. That concludes this video. Hopefully I've earned a like, share, or subscription. If you enjoyed this video, you may enjoy one of these videos as well. Thank you for watching.